2 till 4 every Wednesday live on Eugene Radio. This is number one ever radio station. And joining me today, unfortunately Presto cannot be with us, but I'm going to play, so, not the second evening, but the last one before.
On the last show.
On the last
show,
we've got Mr. Slade.
You need to be down
there. Of the show, you decide what I play, so you can text now 81869.
When the world is bad enough. Amazing, you're nothing. Do you do the wrong? Yes, it's fine. Do you have to do it again and do it? it's your butt, it's your butt. And I know it's a struggle, because you're putting in the effort to get a man. But it's feeling like a hustle. When you face neglect, compare me with your ex. Well, you can go ahead, man, you can go ahead. Check, because it's always the same beat. And when something goes wrong, I know it's too long, but you're still trying to find a way to blame me. And when we're over, I bet you always be the one telling me I need closure. Man, I'm feeling like a donut. I'm rather giving you my heart, so you got me over. I'm not scared of commitment, no. It's just not what I want right now. You say that I've got to give you full time, not part time. I'm not watching my clock right now. Wow.
Thank you. tell you this, there is an interesting bit of footage where he could not get any water.
Amazing.
So they kept running out of water on the bus. And there was two moments when he really needed water, and they had no water for him for very few days. A second request for an inquiry into severance payments made to former executive staff. The councillors from different parties want the City Council's own audit committee to investigate payments made to former City Director Nicola Yates, who reportedly received £200,000 on leaving the council in 2016, and former Chief Executive Alec Musky, who left with a reported £70,000 after resigning last year. The payments have dogged Bristol Mayor Marvin Rees, who's always maintained the council were merely fulfilling contractual obligations. Pete Simpson is our political report.
I do understand that the Chief Executive Audit Committee is sympathetic to their request. I do think it's unlikely to happen. We'll have to see. They're due to meet again, the Audit Committee, a week today. Put it in your diaries.
Labour has promised to settle the vast majority of the outstanding cases of alleged anti-Semitism within the party by the end of July. The chairman of the Jewish Leadership Council, Jonathan Goldstein, described the Labour leader's response as shrugging his shoulders at us. But the Shadow International Trade Secretary, Barry Gardner, insisted that Mr. Corbyn was taking decisive action.
He has written to every member of the party, setting out what is being done and why this is totally unacceptable. But on all the points about action, and it's action that matters here. It's not words, it's actions that matter. And actions are being taken by the party to make sure that this is dealt with.
Government sources have dismissed claims there were heated exchanges between Theresa May and the Foreign Secretary in Cabinet over immigration policy. It's understood Boris Johnson called for an amnesty for some illegal immigrants and a wider exemption for more Commonwealth citizens. The anonymous artist who placed a 10-foot statue of a woman pensioner outside a Healthy Aged shop in central Bristol is the same man who placed the angel sculpture outside the BRI earlier this year. He says it's a tribute to Ruth, a friend of his who was in a care home and decided to liven things up for the other residents. He says he doesn't expect or want the work to last.
The point is, regardless of how it's three-dimensional, this is still street art. The street art isn't meant to last. It's meant to come. I mean, it's interesting, coincidentally, that the first female statue from Martin Fonsworth, the recent portrait, and the issue had about that. The problem with those sort of statues is that it's going to have to be a question.
And pupils at a school in Maelby are making sandwiches for Bristol's homeless population today. The children at St. Francis Catholic Primary are dropping things and will make the sandwiches this morning until they get delivered by the charity later tonight.
It's a monument brought to you. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.